It's time for some hoops at the Bradley Center, home of the Bucks, and we're going to bring it to you live on 2K Sports. It's a one-game reprieve at home for the Bucks, here with their Milwaukee fans, and then back on the road. Still early in the season, but the front office and coaching staff likes what they are seeing from this team so far. Better winning percentage than last year.
Well, right now for the Bucks, they've become a team that you really have to watch out for. I mean, just look at where they are in the standing. Remember where they were last year at this time? A big difference.
Yeah, big difference, Clark. It was a tough season a year ago, and as a result, you know, there weren't a lot of expectations coming into this season. So I like what this club has done.
Hey, what's up, guys? Going up against the Milwaukee Bucks on the road. We're 5-1. We're going to try to keep this winning streak going that we have in five games.
He has five.
But I have a pretty big task of keeping Steven Jackson from putting up major points.
Back to Durant.
I'm going to try my best, though.
Jackson with it. Shot clock at six.
So I'm not letting Steven Jackson get past me. And he's going to try to fire up a three in my face, but I'm not letting that happen.
Can't get it to go.
So right now, I mean, Phoenix, we're doing all right. There's a lot of close games that we barely end up winning. But, you know, we really don't have any problems as far as, you know, teamwork, I guess. But Steve Nash makes a nice move right there. He kicks me the ball. The only issue I have with this team is Aaron Brooks. Like, I seriously wish he would get traded. And right there, I make a new move and leave my guy wide open. And I get charged for, you know, leaving.
Takes a lot of shots. He doesn't but always make
I make a nice jumper so you need your on the baseline out off the fast break, so
it allows you to get
it's not
back
that
defensively,
bad.
And it allows you to really be able to count on.
And of course, Phoenix tied in first place with them.
Well, right
so
now,
right now
the
standings,
they've gotten off to exactly
six
the
games
kind of
into the season, it may be just a small Phoenix and side, Dallas are tied
really
for first at 5-1. And the Lakers are 4-2.
Done a nice job of putting together
and then I'm pretty sure
this team is
Oklahoma City is in
competing on a nightly basis, and they built some early
third place.
Jennings with
I'm
the
pretty
bucket.
Sure. But I need to double check that.
And Vince Carter certainly, Steve, could hit some tough shots. The downside, Clark, was, of course, sometimes maybe he settled.
Right here, I'm trying to get around Carter. I didn't mean to run into him for him to pass me the ball. But they're not. The defense isn't tight, so I'm going to take a nice jumper. Square him up with the crossover and then take the shot.
Getting their first look of the season at the Bucks in this one.
Well, some called their series last year kind of a
but right here, I like it when I'm in at shooting guard and I get to run a play because it gets me an assist. Like, as you saw right there, I wouldn't be able to do that as a shooting guard.
Beautiful dish there and a superb finish.
So I did a pretty good job setting up Carter for that three.
Now here's Jackson.
There's another play. I try to cut these plays off. Because my teammates do end up getting stuck on those screens because they don't run around them. So I have to help out.
Suns leading by five.
Right here, Nash is going to kick me the ball again because they're going to leave me open. I'm hit a jumper.
Good, and the assist goes to Nash.
And Nash is just, you know, serving good baskets right now. I mean, he's aware. And, you know, we're up, you know, we got a pretty good, decent lead. I think this is where they started getting off on us. Right here, I get charged with leaving my assignment, and I didn't even move anywhere. I don't, like, 2K needs to fix this because that's my teammate grade. And that just took a big chunk out of my teammate grade because I almost had a B. And now I'm back to that B minus. And if I had a 3, I would have taken that shot, but I haven't really touched my three-pointer. It's still at a 79. So I'm going to take it inside because I have upgraded my shooting traffic and my mid-range jumper. So, you know, we're doing a pretty good job on offense right now. And they're going to set me back in at shooting guard. And Aaron Brooks is in the game right now. So I'm expecting us to lose this lead.
That's the five on the floor for the Bucks.
I'm pretty sure we're going to lose this lead. It's just the Aaron Brooks effect.
Second chance effort. Shot's good from Mbamute.
He makes the most of his chances on the offensive glass, doesn't he?
So I get to run another play. And I was thinking about kicking the ball to Brooks, but he misses too many shots. So I was like, just kick the ball in the corner. But for some reason, Fry threw the ball to Hill, and I'm confused. Right here, I'm going to give the ball back to Fry. He's going to get a nice, you know, I don't even know what to call that. It wasn't a layup. I'm guessing, I don't know.
Well, defensively, they're doing a nice
and
job
he kicked me the ball too early. My screen wasn't even set. But right here, I'm going to, you know, draw some attention inside, kick it back out. It's something I'm realizing that I can do that on defense because we get cheesed on that so much. I'm going to start doing it to the other team. And I get charged with leaving my assignment. But I was just cutting the screen. But I didn't feel like getting stuck. So I think leaving your assignment, they need to chill that out. Because that's getting called way too much. And Brooks is going to fire an unnecessary three. Didn't finish the play.
This seemed like one of those nights, guys. They never could get it going offensively.
Yeah, they didn't have much going at that end of the floor, and even when they got something positive to happen with their defense, it didn't carry over to the other end.
And I'm not letting this guy shoot the ball in my face. Are you serious? It's not happening.
Very few mistakes from him at that end of the floor.
Not a great year for the Bucks, and as they were eliminated from playoff
contention, so I was thinking about running this play.
Jennings led his unhappiness with that and with the roster turnover.
But I think I made a nice move right there.
Demonstrative about it.
The shot's good.
And I kicked the ball in. He kicked it back out, which is all right. I was trying to get the assist for myself.
Gortat with a screen on Jennings.
Should have kicked the ball to Carter because he had that split second, but I had a load of room right there, so I took the jumper. And it's halftime. And I'm leading the team with 12 points, which is all right, I guess. I mean, it's always nice to lead your team in scoring. So we have too many turnovers. That's
for the
ridiculous.
Phoenix Suns, they have the lead against the Bucks at Bradley Center. The three-point shooting, ridiculous. They're knocking down everything.
I'm in the halftime highlights.
He's got 10
That's
points and
sweet.
Has been contributing on the boards, too. And on the other side, Milwaukee just keeps scrapping. They're looking to climb above 500 here in the early going. We've seen Steven Jackson having a superb game. He's already racked up 18 points and has added some assists to his totals.
Steven
as
Jackson
well.
Basically is their offense right now. So, you know, we're going to start the... I'm going to get subbed in the third quarter.
The Bucks trail. So with Nash sitting on the bench, here's who Alvin Gentry's going.
Honestly, I'm really tired of Aaron Brooks. And there's Carter.
And
there's a
and
secondary
point
guard, even though I'm killing him in minutes
Brooks
right
covering.
Now.
Now Boykins, here's Jackson. And unable there to get
I'm
the
not letting
button.
Jackson hit that
he just
shot.
Couldn't shake loose. He had the defender draped all over.
Thought Jennings was going to take the shot. I'm glad I didn't jump early.
Now, here's Childress. Not a lot of room.
Childress doesn't do anything with the ball, so I'm going to come get it. And I almost get stripped there, but I do a pretty good job of shielding myself.
With one on the clock.
And I'm going to get a cheesy jumper right there.
That one's good. Here is Brooks.
I have to set a screen here. Attack the man, and then I try to run through, continue the play.
Jackson against Robertson.
I thought I was going to draw Childress'
side.
Defender inside.
Jackson, again,
but I'm shaking Jackson, so I just took a shot.
Up this quarter, providing a hot hand to help carry them offensively.
And here is Brooks.
I mean, this game is pretty close. It's we're kind of losing our grip because Aaron Brooks has been in the game too long, and we're losing that offensive production that we get from Steve Nash. But I'm going to kick the ball outside, and Childress is going to be left all alone. And Steve Nash is back in the game, so we're going to try to get back in this game. I mean, just the play of Aaron Brooks, just we
Jackson against Robertson.
The reason we lost that last game was because of Aaron Brooks.
Gets it to go.
And I get a pretty – that I shouldn't have forced the ball like that, but I wasn't trying to get a turnover, and it ended up being a good pass. So it's all good.
Elite defender, but he did give them an interior presence. Hopefully – Gortat can give them some of that toughness inside this season.
And you're asking a lot out of your
And they talk about Gortat. Gortat actually is, I like him as an inside man. He's not that bad. I mean, his jumper could be worked on a little bit. But it's all good. And Mbadamute is trying to bully me right here. But I'm just going to mess him up, kick the ball into Gortat. He's going to get points right there. And start of the fourth quarter. We're up 2 points. We're losing. We lost our lead. We've been going back and forth for a while.
Now, as we get going here in the fourth, let's send it over to Doris Burke for our Sprite Spark.
Well, for the Suns, their spark has been from the great play of their point man off the bench. He's been his team's secret weapon off the bench in this one, as he's given his team valuable minutes. We'll see how it ends, guys.
Great, Doris. Thanks. He has been a true catalyst, Clark, off the bench.
Boy, I tell you what, man, he gave them something they've been lacking. I mean, it basically changed their attitude and their disposition out there. I mean, he had that kind of impact.
And that's something you don't always see, guys. I mean, a player coming in off the bench and assuming a leadership role, that was impressive.
Drew Gooden.
That is the first time I have ever really gotten a shout out. And I do not come in at all during the fourth quarter. Kind of disappointing because we do end up losing this game by such a large margin. And I thought, you know, maybe the coach would have put me in. But, you know, we'll just get him next time. I think we do end up playing the Bucks two more times, I think, this season. So I get all of my objectives. I had a B minus, had a couple highlight plays. So it's kind of disappointing. Here's my final stats for the game.
Obviously the team didn't bring it tonight. How does the way you prepare for the next game change after a loss like this?
I was honestly a little upset that I didn't come in the fourth quarter, but I didn't want to, you know, answer the question negatively. So, you know, I'm just going to go with a nice answer.
Well, it gives me some extra motivation, I know that much. And I hope the same is true for my teammates. Nobody in this league should ever feel good about losing like we did tonight. If I don't light a fire underneath every single player on this team, I'm going to be disappointed. But knowing these guys, I bet they're just as fired up as I am. And that means we're going to come out strong next game. You can count on that.
I don't understand how I got a negative you know, my buzz went down. But I got another game coming pretty soon, so catch you guys later.